Hi there. So let's talk about five things that are required on every discussion forum post, unless otherwise noted in the instructions. Number one is easy. Get it in on time. Every assignment in this class has a due date and time. Get your work in on time or else I'm not going to accept it. Number two, proofread. It's another easy one, but you might not have known this. While you're typing, Canvas runs a spell check for you. For instance, you can see I misspelled the word error, and Canvas lets me know with the little red squiggly lines. Be on the lookout for those things. If you see them, fix them. Another thing that might be helpful, after you've written your post, go back over and read it at least once. Proofreading can help you catch things that you missed in the heat of the moment while typing. Now, you're also required to use MLA formatting in this class, and that applies to any piece of evidence that you cite, whether it's a line of poetry from your anthology or a big chunk of text from a peer-reviewed source. I don't expect you to have MLA formatting memorized. The OWL at Purdue is a great resource. I still use it, so why wouldn't you? In this class, we'll be using an anthology called Backpack Literature. So I will scroll down here on the OWL at Purdue until I found a work in an anthology. And here's the template. Of course, you'd have to replace all these placeholders with the applicable names and titles, but it's a lot better than building it from scratch. So you can see in my example post here, I cited a line of poetry, so I included a line number, that's my in-text citation, and a works cited entry to my anthology. Of course, I haven't built it yet, but you get the idea. All right, once you've done all of that, you got to decide, do you want help? Some people do and some don't. Let's talk about that for just a minute. We're all adults here, it's a college-level course. Sometimes we're putting stuff out there and we want feedback. We want to grow from it. If that's you, put help at the top of your post, just at the very top like this. This lets me know that you want me to leave comments, and it lets your classmates know that you're welcome and open to their comments. Now, sometimes you don't want help and you don't want feedback, and there's nothing wrong with that. Sometimes we put something out there, we know it's not our best work, we just want the points because we don't want the zero. Sometimes we know we're going to change our minds and not use that idea, and I always encourage students to grow and not be, you know, too committed to an idea. If that's you, don't put help. It's not a big deal at all. I'll just give you a grade and move on to the next student who does want my comments. We're all adults here. You know, my feelings are not going to be hurt. I'm here if you need me, but I'm not going to load you down with menial feedback if you're not going to read it. Okay, the final thing, leave feedback for your classmates. And don't just go in and put, nice job. That's not helpful. In this class, I require that you leave helpful, constructive feedback. That means find something that could be better and point out some kind of suggestion, offer a way to fix it. That's being constructive. For example, in my post here, notice I misspelled the word error. A helpful piece of feedback might say, you've got a typo here. Error is actually spelled E-R-R-O-R. On future posts, it might be a good idea to proofread one more time before you submit it. Find something that could be better. Hopefully not all of your feedback is as superficial as what I just did. Hopefully you can find, you know, weaknesses and ideas and point those out and offer ways to strengthen those ideas. That would be great. But the point is, don't just tell somebody, this looks great, nice work. That's not helpful. You can be constructive. You can find flaws and still be respectful. And that's part of the process in this class. So there you have it. Five requirements on all discussion forum posts, unless otherwise noted. If you have any questions at any point throughout the semester, shoot me an email and I'll get right back to you.